Pangaea PHG-100 digital gas detector uses a high-sensitivity sensor. The 14-inch flexible probe allows detection in difficult and hard-to-reach areas. A large LED display can show from 0 up to 9999 ppm. The changing speed of the sounds will alert you when the gas leaks are detected. Let's do a simple test to demo how it works. We fill an empty bottle with some gas with a gas lighter. Pangaea PHG-100 digital gas detector uses 3 AA batteries. Just turn it on. Wait a few seconds. When you see zero on the LED screen, then you will hear tick sound from the speaker. Now it is ready to detect. We move the probe closer to the opening of the bottle. You will then hear the ticks get faster, and the digital display changes quicker, showing the gas concentration level in ppm. Let's try again. The digital value increases, and ticks become faster again. That's when you know you've spotted the gas leaks. Compared to traditional gas leak detectors, Pangaea PHG-100 digital gas detector is easier to use and more accurate. You will not miss even the slightest leaks.
Illitech WJL6000 refrigerant leak detector adopts a Corona refrigerant sensor. Open the battery cover. Install 4 AAA alkaline batteries and reinstall the cover. Turn on the detector. It takes no more than 6 seconds to warm up until it beeps. The detector has 7 adjustable sensitivities. You can adjust the sensitivity to your needs. When a leak is detected, a siren will be sounded with a rate quite different from the previous beep sound, and the indicator lights will flash increasingly. After use, turn the knob counterclockwise to turn off. Leaking areas are usually covered with contaminants such as compressor oil or dirt. Be careful to keep these contaminants away from the sensor tip. Keep the sensor tip away from touching any moisture or other solvent to avoid false alarm.
Hello guys, this is our latest upgrade Corona gas detector with LCD. Let's see what's in the box. A 3/8 tape, a USB cable, the gas detector, a pair of screws, an adapter, and an instruction manual. We can see that the accessories are obviously much more than Corona J1. Let's take a look at its new design and new features. The first one, LCD screen is the highlight feature. It shows real-time gas leakage concentration. We will talk about it later about the details. The second, the working voltage is DC 5V with 2 pins, which means that using a mobile charger is available now. But please notice that there is no built-in battery. We always recommend you to use a sustainable power supply to ensure its 24 hours of monitoring. The third one, 1-inch micro USB interface is at both upper and lower sides. Considering its 2 different kinds of installing locations, the design is much more convenient and flexible for users. If you're worried not to have a long enough USB cable, there is a 79-inch extension USB cable in the box. Corona gas detector is with both audio and visual alarms. It detects natural gas and liquefied petrol gas. Please install it correctly as the instruction manual says. The next we'll see how it works with power on. There is a button here. Let's plug it on a socket and see what's going to happen. Press the button to run self-test. Red line, yellow line, and green line will flash one by one with one beep. Then we warm up for 100 seconds with flashing green light. Please be patient for the countdown shown in the LCD. While waiting for it, we can say that the LED light is very eye-catching and is so bright. I think no one could just ignore it at the night with limited illumination in the room. That's what a gas detector should be. The light is very beautiful, but don't think yourself is in a club when you see this. Please mind the gas. Okay, the countdown is over. LCD shows 0.0% and the green light stops flashing, but it starts breathing. Well, how does Kazuna gas detector make the alarm? Let's take this lighter to test. You can also run a test like this, but please absolutely make sure that you are in a good place to do so. Okay, you can see the digits on the LCD is changing very fast. When it shows 0% to 2%, the light is flashing green without any beeps. It means that there is no gas leakage. But when it shows 2% to 5%, the light changes to yellow but without any beeps. But for this, you should pay attention on your gas, as it means that slightly there is a gas leakage in your room. When LCD shows 5% to 20%, the light will rapidly flash in red with rapid beeps. You must eliminate the danger immediately, as it means that there is a very high concentration gas leakage in your room just now. The alarm is very sensitive and rapid responding. Kazuna gas detector is a reliable product which you can enjoy a 2-year warranty. If you buy the product but think not satisfied at your concern, it is fine to contact Amazon for a refund or replacement, or contact Kazuna customer service. Better safe than sorry, Kazuna can do. At the end of the video, I have to say that Kazuna gas detector is a super important part of a home security system, even for the ones with hearing inconveniences, as its LED light and LCD digital display are super sufficient for them to instantly aware what is going on in their surroundings, so that the danger can be eliminated in time. For more information, please check out our menu. Thank you for watching.
Congratulations and thank you for purchasing a TechMate refrigerant leak detector, one of the best-selling leak detectors in the world. This instructional video will show you how to set up your new TechMate and begin finding leaks. TechMate comes in a rugged carrying case to help protect your investment. Begin by unclipping the case and removing TechMate and the supplied D-cell batteries. To install the batteries, use a small flat screwdriver to remove the battery cover. Install the batteries and close the battery compartment. All new TechMates ship with a new sensor in a sealed package. A new sensor should last about 100 hours, depending on the application and the exposure to refrigerants. To install the sensor, remove the rubber sensor cover on the face of the TechMate and cut open the sensor package. Be careful not to bend the three small prongs on the sensor during installation and handling. Install the sensor in the TechMate and reinstall the rubber cap. A filter is pre-installed in the TechMate probe tip. If the filter looks dirty or gets clogged with dirt or oil, replace it with one of the replacement filters included with your TechMate. To replace the filter, use a paper clip or small tweezers to remove the old filter and install a new one by pushing it into place. Once the batteries and sensor are installed, long press the power button to turn TechMate on. On startup, TechMate will alarm to indicate the sensor is warming up. This could last for a few minutes. Eventually, it will slow down to a steady beep. TechMate is now ready to find leaks. TechMate always starts in high sensitivity. This mode is useful for finding the general source of the leak. Begin by moving the probe slowly around the suspected leak. TechMate will beep faster the closer it is to the leak until a continuous beep is heard. Move the probe away from the suspected leak for a few moments and repeat to verify the leak. Next, switch to low sensitivity by pressing the power button. Continue to move TechMate through the leak source until you have narrowed the leak source down to a specific point. Keeping the probe in the same concentration of refrigerant for an extended amount of time will zero TechMate to that concentration. Moving the probe away from that area will reset the zero point. Turn TechMate off by long pressing the power button. TechMate will let you know when the batteries are low by flashing the power indicator. When the batteries are completely dead, the power and high indicators will alternate. Inficon's worldwide sales, service, and distribution network means that no matter where you are, we can assist you. Contact us with any questions you might have. Inficon, laboratory accurate, toolbox tough.
While detecting the gas leaking, the red LED flashes. It takes about 1 minute to warm up. When it comes to green light, you can keep some gaps around in distance of 5 cm to the gas convection hose by using an ignition lighter. Alarm will be sounded when the detector detects a smell of gas.